Those wanting to delve into the surrounding desert will be delighted with the granite mountains and the surrounding canyons. Choose from different levels of hiking trails that is available also, and also jeep tours into the Negev desert. Most of the trail is ideal for families, while the winding path through the mountains offers a challenge for serious bikers. The bicycle trail within the city is now under construction and expected to reach as far as the Peace Promenade at the Gulf of Aqaba over the next few years. Look for one of their guard posts and you will see the Egyptian flag. About 10 minutes past the turnoff for Ain Natafen, a sign leads to the Red Canyon and a dirt road takes you a long way down into a large parking lot. Minutes north of Eilat, as the crow flies, lies the stunning geological wonder that offers an undisturbed hike through the natural canyon. The Red Canyon gets its name from the phenomenon which occurs when sunlight hits the reddish rock that lies and lines the canyon. It then glows with an intense reddish color. Once you embark on this adventure and near the end of your ride, you will see the Egyptian border on your left. There are no buildings anywhere around, and you can see the highway from the parking lot or the trail, giving you a delicious sense of being in the wilderness. It is always open, there is no fee, but you must be out of the canyon way before it gets dark. It is only a short walk to the Nahal Sinai main twisting riverbed. Flowers growing in the Wadi range from white brush with the delicate blossoms in winter and the early spring to the saltbush. desert foliage suffers from heat, lack of water, and brackish ground, for there is little rain to wash away the salt in the soil. Salt bush adapts itself to the climate by exerting excess salt into its leaves. A greenish gray plant about a meter and a half high, the salt bush gets its color from the tiny hairs on its leaves, which protects it from a strong rays of the sun.
Unfortunately, we'll
Are you looking at me? I can't really see you. Okay.
Imitation. You get other brains. Which.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Did you know that the sunbush leaves are tasty and mentioned in Job as food for the hungry men who roam these wastelands? In the brush, they gathered salt herbs, and that's in Job 30 verse 4. You can eat the leaves right off the bush or cook them at home. Some people had these leaves in omelets before and also in vegetarian meatballs, while the Bedouin add them as seasoning to flour before baking pita. Thank you. Soon the riverbed begins a steep descent to the canyon, a red sandstone gorge less than 300 meters and only 2 to 4 meters wide. By the end of the canyon, you will have descended several dozens of meters. Some of the canyon sandstone rock is truly ancient, hundreds of years old, and covered with a later conglomerate. Huge limestone boulders swept here during floods have stuck in the gorge and created steps. The sides of the gorge are composed of gorgeous rock formations in stunning colors. A group of these rocks and sandstone adds extra height to the sides of the canyon. These colors are exceptionally exquisite when sunlight hits the canyon walls at a certain time of the day. And one should admire and take in all these breathtaking colors. The Red Canyon is a short section of Wadi Sani that starts its way in the Sinai Desert in Egypt, crosses the border and continues through the Eilat Mountains. At some point, the wadi carves its way deep into the red sandstone, creating a narrow and impressive canyon. This section is known as the Red Canyon. A hike through the Red Canyon is one of the most popular routes in the Eilat Mountains. There are several places inside the treacherous landscape where you would climb down the rock wall using ladder steps. This seems awfully far apart. If you are short or out of shape, descending with these ladders seems endless. Scary though it can be, you can't help but be excited when you reach the end of this climb. Immediately upon leaving the narrow part of the canyon, a trail climbs up the southern wall on the right-hand side and returns to the parking lot. Immediately upon leaving the narrow part of the canyon, trail climbs up the southern wall on the right-hand side and returns to the parking lot. Hikers taking this exciting trail should be careful, for it runs all along the edge of the canyon. Get too close and the crumbling rocks on the on the top may fall on the heads of someone that is below in the canyon. So one should be very careful of loose rocks that might lie around and slip and then fall into the canyon.